السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. I hope that everybody is fine. Today is Thursday, and before we start our important topics, discussing the admin cost in the charitable activity, we have to send our condolence and make our dua to the victims in Syria, the victims of the chemical weapon in the area.
Khan Sheikhoun.
As well as before that, in Mosul as well, 200 people also have been mercilessly killed more than a week ago. So may Allah bless the souls of the people who martyred in these two attacks and comfort the hearts of their friends, brothers, sisters, and families. Make a dua and read from the Holy Book to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for their acceptance in heaven. Today is a very crucial and important topic for all of us. It's ongoing discussion, at least during my career in the humanitarian work over the last 35-40 years. Admin cost, what it is. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Tawbah mentioned Al-Amirin alayha as one of the 8 categories of spending money on Al-Amirin alayha, the people who collect zakat and the people who distribute zakat. So there's a category in the Holy Quran to say that you have to, from the money of zakat, to spend money on the people who work to collect and distribute zakat. Admin cost is needed for any work that we do on this planet, whether it's charity, whether it's political, whether it's business, whether it's social, anything. We need money to run it. Okay? We need money to run it. Next, please. There is no work on this planet. This is the golden rule that for all of us have to understand. No work could be done which call it 0% admin cost. The only 0% admin cost is where you people, inshallah, go to heaven. Where everything is done for us, food, drink, clothes, everything. For free by Allah, because this is the land or the place of comfort, joy, and leisure that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is preparing for all of us. But on this planet, admin cost is a very important part of constructing life, developing life, and maintaining life of human being and other creation of Allah. No one should claim that his organization is zero admin cost at all, even if we don't pay money for the admin cost. Next, please. Types of administration. There are two types of administration, financial and non-financial. The financial one, which you know it, money. The non-financial could be the voluntary values, could be in kind donation, voluntary values that you volunteer for the organization. Could be in kind donation, like you give clothes, you give shoes, you give food, you give anything of this. Second-hand furniture, this is what we call in kind donation. Intellectual, which means the intellectual and capability of somebody who can give you a great idea. This great idea is money. This in-kind donation is money. Voluntary activity is money. You have to convert all this into the equivalent of cash which you spend. Because you don't want you to be fooled by saying we spend only 5% on the finance, but you have to calculate this as well. Okay? Clear? Let us look at our startup organization, charitable organization, humanitarian organization, voluntary organization. At the initial stage, most, if not all, the work is done voluntarily by people in the surrounding, in the neighborhood. If you go to a mosque, or to a church, or to a synagogue or to a temple, in this street or in this avenue, he found the nearby houses have good. People love the spirit of the holy places. So they give food, they give time, they give effort, they give everything to the mosque, the church, the synagogue, the temple. So really, in a case like this, I jumbled. This is the foundation. In the foundation, most of the work is done voluntarily. We might not have any financial admin cost. But we have a non-financial admin cost. The volunteering. In the foundation stage, like we decided to make an organization today, we start there for 6 months or a year, and we all giving our money, our time for free, and this could go up to 100% the non-financial admin cost. Okay, this is the foundation stage. Okay? The charity work, if we look at the case of the mosque, mosque and church and synagogue,
this mosque.
Admin cost could be 2-3%. Why? Because the neighborhood of the mosque, of the synagogue, of the church is contributing voluntarily to help running the mosque, the church, the synagogue, the temple, as well as giving food and time and money, not money even. So most of this is done, you see, like here, we might need this 2-3%, okay, to have some stationaries, some other things, but could be less than that. Because we have one project that the community, the surrounding community, is supporting it 100%. And this happens also in other areas where we have initiatives by people, and we have other organizations who work on the same level. The level of the avenue, the street. Because you can walk it, you can leg it out from this side of the avenue to this side of the avenue, from this side of the street to this side of the street. So the cost might not be high. Because most of this cost, with 97%, will be non-financial contribution by the neighborhood. In the mosque, in the synagogue, in the temple. Okay? As much as we said earlier on, could be 100%. In the cases of the foundation stage of any charitable activity. So it could go from the foundation stage, could be 100% non-financial admin cost, 100% non-financial admin cost, which is the volunteering, 2-3% for the mosque and synagogue with financial admin cost. Clear? Clear? If it's not clear, please send a message. Now we go out from the neighborhood to the village, okay, and the city. We need some money to get some part-timer to work inside this organization, to answer telephone, to write letters. So the admin cost goes from 3%, 2-3%, for the mosque and synagogue and church, into 5%. Because in this, the area becomes bigger. It's not a street, it's not an avenue, it's a village. Might have 500 houses. It's a small town. Might have the same number, or a small city. So it goes up to 5%. Because we need somebody to do the bookkeeping, the financial bookkeeping, the administration bookkeeping. But still, we depend on the volunteering of the community in the surrounding area, in the village, and in the town. So from the foundation stage, zero financial cost, but 100% non-financial admin cost to the mosque and synagogue and church, 2 to 3%, to the village and the town is up to 5%. Okay? Clear? If you are confused, please let me know. Send me a message. It keeps going up to the area of the province and the government. Muhafza. It goes from 5 to 10% because you have more work to be done inside the office. More work to be done inside the office. And we don't need to fool ourselves by saying that we don't need staff to run this work on the level of the government on the province. If we remember the good old days of Umar ibn Khattab and the companion of the Prophet or the disciples of Isa and Musa, they used to walk it from this end of Medina to this end of Medina. Few houses, they come listen to them day and night. But the community of Medina is not with us anymore. We don't have Umar, we don't have Abu Bakr, we don't have Uthman. We don't have the small community of Medina. It's a big, complex community. Big, complex community. So we have to employ people to look after the operation, the daily operation. On the government levels, it goes from 5 to 10%. Okay? I have to be very clear that the more you grow, very clear, the more you grow, the more the work becomes complex, the more the admin cost becomes, the financial admin cost becomes. Clear? If it's not clear, please come back to me. The more the operation becomes complex and wider geographical distribution goes from the avenue to the village, to the town, to the government. From 2 to 3% to 5% to 10%. 5 to 10%. Nothing for free. Nothing for free or zero financial contribution. Okay? Next one. Please. On the national level, of course, if you're working in a country like UK, okay, from Scotland in the north to from the Shetland, from Aberdeen to Southampton or Bournemouth. Or in a country like Egypt, from Alexandria to Aswan, or Sudan, from Shindi Akbara to it used to be Juba in the good old days. Now it's still, I can't remember the line of demarcation. Saudi Arabia is the same, okay, Jordan the same, Iraq the same, so on. On the national level, the percentage will go up. As I said earlier on, the more, the wider the geographical work, the more the admin, the financial contribution to the admin cost will be. So if you take the case of Yemen, 24-25 districts, the case of Egypt, 26 districts, Algeria is a huge country, big country. So on France, the same. You can't govern, you can't cover the whole country with 2, 3, 5, or 0%. It goes up from 10% to 15%. National level goes up from 10%. And people who tell you less, they might be fooling you. They are not transparent, and they are using this media or PR activities to fundraise, to say that we are zero, we are 1%. You can't be 0 or 1% because you have a headquarter, you have an operation in the headquarter, then you have offices in different countries. If you talk about Syria, even the operation for Syria, the Syria in Turkey, Syria inside Syria, Syria in Jordan, Syria in Lebanon. So Lebanon, Turkey, Jordan, Syria. That's 4 operations. Plus your headquarters. nothing in the international work is less than 15%. Could go more than that. You have to be very wise of not making it more than 20%. Okay? Well, I'm talking about it from my own experience. You can challenge me, you can say I'm wrong. But this is what I have been seeing, and so I'm telling all of us. For the donors, they have to understand that actually the admin cost, financial contribution for the admin cost at any level of the operation. That does not mean that the donor has to throw the money by himself or herself because it's 0%. This is wrong. This is wrong. You have to build the organization. You have to trust the organization. You have to raise the quality and improve the productivity of the organization, because in certain areas you cannot deliver it yourself. You have to give it to this organization. And even for some of the people who think that they can go and make foundation because they are worthy, good, but not good enough. The foundation will be like the mosque organization. Money giving. But if you want quality of the delivery, if you want efficiency, if you want value for the pound, if you want value for the dollar, if you want impact, you have to build stronger organization, even if it takes the 10 or 15 or the 20%. And this is the reality of life. This is the reality of life. We are living it because of the complexity of the conflicts that we are seeing every day, every now and then, and the natural disasters, and the wider global geographical area that we have to cover, and. So in any international operation, it goes from 15 to 20%. If you are not agreeing with me, you can send me a message, okay? Because we need staff. Full-time staff, we need specialized staff, we need quality staff. And we are being governed by the law of counter-terrorism, counter-extremism, counter-radicalism. Be careful of saying international operation is costing me 2 or 3%. Tell this organization, sorry, you are not saying the truth. And refer and use my name to them. Can I have 1 second more, please? Let us talk about conflict zones. I mentioned Syria before. I mentioned Syria as a conflict zone. It has Lebanon, it has Syria, it has Jordan, it has Turkey. It has 7 million displaced people inside Syria. It has 4 to 5 million refugees in the 3 neighboring countries. This is Syria. If we talk about the conflict in South Sudan now, people are leaving the conflict zone to the neighborhood, the towns and villages around the capital. If we talk about Yemen, there's Taiz, there's Sana'a, there's Aden, there's other areas. Many displacement inside the city. The conflict zone governed by different rules. Rules of access, rules of delivery, rules of counter-terrorism and counter-extremism, rule of quality, building quality relationship between you and the local community in different areas in the conflict zone. And one of the things which you need to understand in these conflict zones, something called gatekeepers. Like in Somalia, like in Syria, for every area is controlled by a group of armed men. Non-state, we call it non-state actors. They control such an area. But in Somalia, or in Syria, or in South Sudan, or anywhere else. And for the complexity of this, you have to realize that your 15% for the international work could go up to 25% or more. I give an example. Usually I give this example to the South Sudan case scenario. During the conflict in the 70s and 80s, there was a political decision global political intervention by not transferring humanitarian relief goods through the Nile. Because this will strengthen the north against the south. During the rainy season for the South Sudanese, it used to rain for months, so all the roads, were blocked for at least 4 to 5, 6 months. No truck can go through it. It has to be an airdrop. Airdrop could raise the admin cost for the stranded people in the South Sudan to up to 50% or more. And you have seen these airdrops in different areas. And the classical example was in South Sudan. So really, if we have our ulama, our shuyukh, we need them to listen to the practitioner before they give any fatwa, based on the fatwa of the golden era of Medina time. Golden era of Medina time is for Medina time as a value, not as a mechanical operation. As a value, not as a mechanical operation. This case, in geographical area, road condition, he wanted to send goods from Khartoum to Darfur, cost more money, whether by road or by air. The cost in Khartoum is less than the cost in Darfur. Nothing called one size can fit all in the admin cost. Okay? Also in this area, there's now something called health insurance, life insurance, and so on, so on, so on. Because nobody would like to go and work in these conflict zones. Okay, next one, please. This is a transparency, especially in most of the organization in the Gulf area. They have sponsored people by the government, thanks to the government in this area, who's sponsoring employees to come and work for me. But that does not mean that my financial admin cost is 5%. I have to add the salary of those sponsored people as an income, there is an admin cost. Because you might find my financial admin cost is 5%, but the government, my government is giving me a sponsored individual which could raise my admin cost to 15%. If I don't calculate this, I am not honest with my donor. Some people here are donating the money for the rent. You put it inside as an income, then you put it as an admin cost. So we have to be extremely transparent with our donors, whether it's in the Gulf or in here in the UK or in America and the West, by telling thank you for the donor, but you have to calculate any donation. But financial, for my salary, or for my electricity, or for the rent, or for the rate and others. Okay, next please. Even in these areas, it's very difficult. Well, we will treat it like the international, and add it on top of it, 5 to 10%. It's very remote. Go to Niger, go to Mali, go to Chad, go to these areas. No roads, difficult. Four-wheel drives, difficult. No infrastructure, difficult. Okay? Next, please. Now we finished the charitable activities. Let's go to the commercial activity. The most successful company will give you 10% at the end of the year. Which is this, oh, 5% I'd be very happy. 10% I'd be excellent. That means that they take about 90 to 95% admin cost. How much is your interest in the bank? You take 2%, 1.5%, 3%. So 97% goes to the bank. And 2 to 3% come to you. This proves that nothing is for free. In the commercial sector, it goes from 95% admin cost, financial admin cost. Next one, please. Even at home, I'm married. My wife goes to do shopping every weekend. She buys food and other stuff for £150. Okay, for 5 meals. So my wife go there by car. She do the shopping. She does the shopping for 2 hours to buy stuff for £150. She comes home and she cooks 5 meals during the week. Let me calculate with you. This is the financial £150. The money that I paid from my own pocket for my wife to buy the food. Okay, 2 hours for shopping, £20 for her. 2 hours for each meal, okay, by 5 meals, £100. If I consider that the 1 hour cost for my wife in the kitchen is £10. So £20 for the 2 hour shopping, £100 for the 5 meals that she cooks. £5 for the petrol, £5 to buy cleaning stuff to clean the kitchen. So the admin cost of the hundred, the financial, the non-financial admin cost for the £150 is £150. That's why sometimes you say, why should I buy something from a fish and chip shop? The chips cost about £3, but actually it's raw from the supermarket for 50 pence. But by the time you cook it, you do the shopping, it becomes the £3 market. And you look at it. If the total cost of this operation for my family at home is £280, £130 is my wife and the time, and £150 is cash that I pay. So brothers and sisters, when we look at the charity sector, we look at the voluntary sector, we don't want to slash their neck. We want to build an institution to enable such an institution to build the infrastructure of our society. To support this and to decrease the financial admin cost, you know the only solution where? Is when from day one start to build a very strong waqf endowment scheme. And they take for every pound or dollar, maybe 5 cents or 5 pence or 10 pence from the very beginning to enable the organization to have no financial contribution from the donation. But the financial contribution from the admin cost comes from the waqf. If we come back to building the philosophy of the waqf, which was the basic foundation of the civil Muslim state in the good old days. Now still, the waqf or endowment is one of the strong foundation of the civil liberty of the West. Whether it's an education or social advocacy, and building infrastructure. So to cut the story short, if you want to tackle the financial admin cost, build from day one a strong waqf scheme. Educate the community to donate for waqf. But nothing called zero admin cost. It is not right. It is could be a lie. And to compete with one another to raise funds and take the market from our neighbor and our and other organizations themselves. Thank you very much, and I hope that if you have any more questions, you can send it to me. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.